take a moment just to say thank you for the mercy you gave me today. You woke me up this morning, let me see another day. The way you love me is the reason that I give you praise.
There's no one worthy of,
there's none worthy
my praise,
no
one love but you. So I
will glorify
Lord, how magnified.
I give all the honor to you.
Honor to you.
Grandmama, you praise him. It's your grandson. You praise him. Glory. Thank you. Woo! Glory. Thank you, Jesus. Glory. See, that's what a church supposed to do. You're supposed to rejoice with them that rejoice. Amen. Cherie back, her son, didn't have to go through all 8 of them or 9 of them, but God have mercy. Y'all. I want you to get up, everybody here. Could have been yours. Thank you, Jesus. Glory. I know I could have been dead. Shout, run, jump, holler. Could have been yours, could have been you. Should have been yours, should have been you. Oh! That's what I'm talking about, CT. Glory! Jesus. Just use what you got. Use what you got. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God, Lord. I want to thank you. Lord, I want to thank you. is instructing you to get something. Get wisdom.
Get understanding.
Get understanding.
Forget it not.
Don't forget wisdom and understanding.
Neither decline from the words of my mouth.
And don't turn away from what I'm saying now. I'm telling you to get it. I'm telling you to get wisdom, right? I'm telling you to get understanding. And don't forget it. Amen. And I'm telling you out of my mouth right now the instruction what to do. I just told the church that you need to do what? Get wisdom and get understanding. All right?
Forsake her not.
Don't forsake wisdom. I ain't talking about this woman now. When the Bible said in this case, forsake her not, he's calling wisdom a her. He ain't talking about no woman. So, brother, when you read that, it ain't talking about your woman. It's talking about wisdom. Don't forsake it.
And she shall preserve thee.
And she shall keep you. You'll stay alive. Y'all hear me? Uh-huh.
Love her.
Love her.
And she shall keep thee.
And she won't divorce you. Read.
Wisdom is the principal thing.
No, that's what we're talking about. Wisdom is the main thing. It's the base thing. It's the thing that supports everything, that keeps everything. It is the principal thing. Everybody say principal.
Principal.
It is the main thing that something set on or stand on. Wisdom. Read.
Therefore, get wisdom.
Therefore, telling you again, to get wisdom. Uh-huh.
And with all thy getting, get understanding.
And along with your getting, understanding is what you need to get with it. Get understanding. You don't need no understanding if you ain't got no wisdom. What you gonna understand? You don't know nothing, so how can you get it? You ain't got no wisdom and no good sense. What you gonna understand?
Folks.
Let's read. In the church that claiming to be saved. And you cannot persuade them that God had not saved them. You cannot persuade them that what they are saying is wrong. Because they say, I got God, and that's enough. Ignorance is no excuse. When you are saved, you should know the Bible. You should know what God is requiring of you. That's what's wrong with a lot of my members here at Community Temple. You don't know the Bible like you ought to. And don't get mad because I said it open. You don't read it. And if you read it, you don't understand it. It don't make no sense to you what you're reading. But if you had wisdom from God, you will understand what you're reading. You can't hardly teach ignorant folk nothing. What makes them ignorant is because they think they already know. And you try to teach them what they ought to know from the scripture, they acting like they already know it. If I can't teach and instruct you something from this word as your pastor, then you don't need me to preach to you. Amen. God gonna call me and I don't know the scripture well enough to teach you nothing? You better find you somebody who knows something, who can show you what the word said, not what they think. Not what they feel. I just told you the other day, or the last Wednesday, about what one renowned preacher who got doctor degree went to school, and then he is denouncing, whether you believe it or not, what God says. And we were talking about tithes. God said, you robbed me, even this whole nation. Bring ye all the tithes into the storehouse, that there may be meat in my house, and prove me now herewith, it says the Lord of hosts. If you pay tithes, I will rebuke the devourer for your sake. If you pay tithes, God said it, I will open you the window of heaven, and I will pull you out a blessing. He talked about all what he would do, and then he went on and said, if you don't do it, you are cursed with a curse. He went on and said, you will put your money in your pocket as with holes in it. And then for somebody to come up and say, you don't have to pay no tithes, it is disputing what God said. Then they said, that's in the Old Testament. Then you are disputing even what God said yesterday or in history. If you are wise and had wisdom, you would have known that God said he never changes. Amen. That he is the same yesterday, today, and forever. And that whatever God said back then, he mean it today. Amen. And if he said pay back then, did he change and say now you don't have to? If that was the case, then God would have been lying. When you read that, then you need to burn up the Old Testament. Y'all hear me? Amen. Amen. And don't pay tithe. But if you read it, and if that man had read it right, he would have found out that tithing was commended by Jesus. Amen. It's not just an Old Testament thing. It's sprang from the Old Testament, and tithing was not under the law. It was before the law. I'm preaching right now. So you can't say God did away with the law. If he did away with the law, he still didn't do away with tithes. Because you read where Melchizedek paid tithe to Abraham before Moses presented the law. Do I make any sense? Amen. Now, somebody don't believe me because they say I'm ignorant. I don't know the scripture. You right, but the Holy Ghost sure know them. If I rely upon my own wisdom, then that is not the wisdom of God. God said, yea, I take the foolish things, the dumb thing, and confine them that are wise. God's wisdom will make men's wisdom look stupid. Don't it look stupid if God said, do something, I'll bless you, and then you turn around and say, you don't have to do it? What it look like if you tell your son or your daughter to do this, and somebody tell you, don't do what they say? Wouldn't you know that be out of order? Yes, I just thought I'd mention that. That's why my subject today, if we can get it on the screen, what I'm trying to talk about is what?
It's time to get wise.
It's time to get wise. Y'all see that you are spiritual thing. Your concern is about houses and land, money,
goal, ambition, position. That is not important, because all of that will perish. All of that, what I mentioned, is temporarily. Your doctor degree is temporarily. Your schooling is temporarily. Your house is temporarily. Your car is temporarily. Your wife is temporarily. Your husband is temporarily. Your children are temporarily. And when you are involved in those things, then your salvation is temporarily. It's time to wise up. It's time now for every one of you that hear me talking right now is to seek after God while he may be found. Seek after spiritual things. Seek those things which is above, not things of this earth. If we sought after God like we do things, we could be spiritual giants. Time to wise up. All of this death, all of this hardship, all of these criers that are coming into our life, really, it ought to set note that you need to wise up. Spending time working can't hardly be at church. And you conclude, this is what I got to do because I got to live. No, you don't have to live. You can still have a good job and still die. It's time to wise up. Come spiritual. Get down and start praying and asking God to direct your life in a spiritual sense. Stop following after things, trying to impress and trying to get so you can live comfortable. Get in the Lord. Time to wise up. Always arguing and bickering about things. What is things? Little old car. Man, what you worry about a car for? You know, I've been driving this same old car for 5 years. Where you been going? Where you want to go for 5 years? That's what you wanted for. So you rolled in a Cadillac and now you rolled in a Volkswagen. Same thing. You still got there. But I'm just tired of wearing the same old thing. Well, I go naked. I bet you don't. It's time to wise up. We caught up in the economy, caught up in the world system, caught up. All you hear about is Trump, Trump, Trump. What about God, God, God? God got Trump in his hand. God got the whole world in his hand. God got me and you, brother, in his hand. And can't nobody get you out of his hand unless he allow it to be. Time to wise up. There ought to be more folk coming to church, going to church than ever before. But now our church is folding up. Churches are folding up all over the United States. Pastors are walking away from their pulpit because the member won't show up for service. They're not enjoying the company of each other. They're not enjoying the song of Zion. They're not enjoying Bible study. They're not enjoying the preached word.
He set up with his eyes open
and see the little night mouse coming out of the den. And he seek down and grab him for a good meal. Say yes. Only wisdom can do that. Say yes, how is it that a bird, yes, watch this, can build a house in a tree and it rains and storm and he don't get wet? That's wisdom from God. He don't even build a top over his house. I better slow down on that. Wisdom. What make a musk rat guard his musk? That's wisdom. Let me explain that. Can I explain that? Y'all don't know about the muskrat, but let me just get a skunk. Same family. A skunk don't expose or dispense his scent until he really needs to. That's wisdom. Because if he kept sending out every time he wants to, when the enemy come up on him, he won't have nothing left. The enemy got wisdom. He only spurt his scent when he's being disturbed. Say it. He smell real good till you disturb him. And when you disturb him, he let out his wisdom how to live right. Wisdom how to talk right. Wisdom how to do right when everybody doing me wrong. Wisdom. My. I wish I had time with this one. You see, some folk get confused with knowledge. They think that's wisdom. Now, the Bible is a book of wisdom. It also got knowledge. I was riding yesterday with Sister Alice in her car. I don't drive it that much, so I don't know all the little gadgets on it. And when I got in it, the rear view mirror on the side was looking way somewhere else. And I said to her, I kept pushing buttons and the whole mirror with it. Whoop. I said, what's wrong with this thing? I don't want the whole mirror to jump in. I just want the glass on it to move out of there. She said, Bradley, it's a little button right down there on the right. Look over there, punch that little button, a little red light come on. I said, why that? By me not having wisdom to know, having the knowledge, see, knowledge, you got to have wisdom with knowledge. And anyway, I couldn't find it, so she almost had to point to me. It's right there, Bradley. And finally, I hit the right thing and got it corrected. Now, if I had had knowledge, first of all, with button to push, the strength of God worked through them in Jesus' name. Oh, the strength of God in the name of Jesus. Let your anointing come. Let it fall right now. Yes, Lord. Oh, Jesus. Come on. Come on. Praise Him as you go. Oh, God. In Jesus' name. Help them now. Direct them.
what God said do. Hallelujah. Never forget it. It's always necessary to give God praise. Always necessary to be happy. Always, always, in every circumstance, it's necessary to make merry. Thank you, Jesus. Woo! I tell y'all, it's necessary for you to get up and do your dance. Come on, everybody, get up. It's necessary. It's necessary. The Bible says it's God's will for you to be happy, married, to rejoice means to be happy. Yes. Yeah.